5 or 6 years ago, we entered this field, a creative field of public spaces and culture. In the beginning, Expeditio didn't consider, we didn't consider ourselves as an organization dealing with culture. Somehow we saw architecture and planning a little bit different from the cultural field, but within Sostenuto project, which we implemented together with partners from Mediterranean countries, we somehow realized that as an architect we can also contribute to this cultural field. During this 1.5 years project, we try to rethink Balkan public spaces, to understand how they have been used by people, what are the issues regarding public spaces. We organized a number of discussions and focus groups with various stakeholders in order to understand how to improve life in Balkan city squares. This project had a strong regional component, so we implemented some activities jointly with partners from Albania and Macedonia. Regarding Montenegrin public space, particularly Kotor public spaces, because that was our pilot area, and that is an area that we know the best because we live there. It is a medieval structured town that has a number of small squares and public spaces, which are ideal, perfect to be used by different city actors. However, that is not the case today. They're usually commercialized, occupied by restaurants and bars. So local people, when we interview them, they do not have this feeling that these spaces belong to them. And they do not have this feeling that they are welcome to express their creativity and their activities in the public spaces. We did sociological research within this project, which sometimes showed that when we ask people what they miss in the public space, sometimes they would say they miss space, because it was occupied by usually private sector. Another issue which we realized during that project is that the procedures and the policy framework for using public spaces is not by citizens or by creative sector is not always clearly defined by the decision makers or authorities who are supposed to manage public spaces. So usually people do not know how to use public spaces and to make it in a legal way. So that was another issue. We discussed these issues with the authorities during the focus groups and roundtables, and we made a set of recommendations how to improve this condition. It was again a project developed with a number of partners from European countries, and the idea of that project was to try to experiment with empowerment of citizens in public spaces through cultural activities. For us and for other partners, that was very inspiring because we got this opportunity to do some creative activities with citizens. And as for our personal experience, we work with a number of citizens that we usually do not collaborate with so much, and we were impressed how that there is so much creativity and ideas in our surrounding that people can express when they have been given an environment where they can show their ideas and present what they know. we have been lucky to receive grants to continue this project. So in the next few years, we will be dealing with again empowerment or building capacity of creative actors to deal with citizens in public spaces. So that was an outcome from the previous project. We realized that there is not always enough capacity at creative actors to deal with empowerment of citizens, not only in public spaces but in generally. So we will implement that project in the next few years. We are just about to start another Balkan project, again regarding public spaces. This project was funded by Balkan Art and Culture Foundation, and we will implement it jointly with partners from Croatia, from Serbia and from Macedonia. And it will be about building capacities of cultural sector, independent cultural sector regarding activities, artistic activities on sustainable cities issue.